In this module, we will discuss ethical tests and decision-making. In the previous module, you explored morals and ethics generally and examined some common ethical conflicts within EMS and other healthcare professions. Here, you will learn about ethical tests used in healthcare-related decision-making and, upon completion of this module, should be able to define several ethical tests used in healthcare-related decision-making. When confronted with an ethical dilemma, quandary, or paradox, there are three common ethical tests used by healthcare providers to guide their actions. The first is to do no harm. Take the administration of naloxone to an unresponsive patient without knowing whether or not the unresponsiveness was caused by an opioid or not. Many would say it is unethical to administer medication to a patient that is not indicated by the patient's signs and symptoms. So what are the indications for the use of naloxone? A simple indication is the existence of opiate antagonist-induced respiratory depression. If the patient is unconscious, but his or her airway is fine, should naloxone be administered? What if the patient is unconscious and suffering from respiratory depression, but you have no idea or do not believe that the patient's issue is related to an opiate overdose? Is it still okay to administer naloxone in those circumstances? Many paramedics believe it is okay to push some naloxone just in case because naloxone is a relatively innocuous medication with very few side effects. If the patient's problem is related to a narcotic overdose and the naloxone reverses the overdose, then great. Otherwise, there really is no harm done by administering a single dose of naloxone. Another example is the elimination of longboards from many protocols for patient spinal immobilization, as emerging evidence is showing that longboarding patients may indeed be doing more harm than good for those patients. Therefore, if faced with an ethical dilemma and the paramedic has a choice that, if followed, has a very low probability of risk to the patient, so long as the intervention should not result in harm to the patient, it may be reasonable to follow that path. The next ethical test is that of determining what should be done if the paramedic is exercising good faith. Good faith is an honesty or sincerity of intention or lawfulness of purpose. Essentially, the healthcare provider is trying to do the right thing for the right reasons. Viewed from the other direction, good faith involves an absence of fraudulent, wrong, or bad intent. Take the naloxone example again. If the paramedic is struggling to help the unconscious patient maintain an airway and has absolutely no idea what is causing the patient's altered mental status and respiratory depression, the paramedic may want to try administering naloxone just in case. Not only is the administration of naloxone likely to do no harm to even a fully conscious patient, much less one who is unconscious with respiratory depression, the paramedic is acting with a purity of heart and a sincere desire to do the right thing under the circumstances. Therefore, applying a good faith analysis to an ethical quandary may be another ethical test employed by the healthcare provider. Lastly, the paramedic may also try to consider the patient's best interest. When faced with seemingly unreconcilable choices, trying to determine which option is in the best interest of the patient given the particular circumstances is another ethical test that may be used by the paramedic. When looking at our naloxone scenario, what is in the patient's best interest? Does the paramedic administer a medication that is not necessarily indicated because the paramedic does not know the cause of the respiratory depression and altered mental status, yet the patient's best interest, in conjunction with a very low risk of harm, seem to encourage the administration of naloxone in this case because it is worth a shot, so to speak? As you may have noticed, these three ethical tests do not necessarily exist in a vacuum apart from each other. In many cases, a healthcare provider may use a combination of these tests, or maybe all three, at one time to determine what should be a proper course of action given an ethical issue. Options that have a very low risk of harm and are arguably in the patient's best interest are probably very strong options when the healthcare provider is simply trying to do the right thing for the right reasons for the benefit of the patient. Given your completion of this brief module, you should now be able to define ethical tests used in healthcare-related decision-making. This presentation was prepared by Waukesha County Technical College in Pewaukee, Wisconsin, and is distributed with an attribution non-commercial share alike 4.0 International Creative Commons license. Copyright 2019 Waukesha County Technical College. For information on WCTC's numerous fire and EMS educational offerings, please visit us online at wctc.edu.